Are you the type of people that needs a very basic dialogue for something like a tutorial, but because you get bored of editing a few scriptable objects, you decide to go ahead and create a node-based dialogue system with a few more features than what you needed? No? Oh. Well, if you are, you came to the right place. In this series, we are going to be making a basic yet probably more than enough node-based dialogue system. Not only will you be able to make a skip to next dialogue combination, you will also be able to add choices. I'll also be adding a basic feature called grouped dialogues where you can select a group and only dialogues inside that group show up. Good for you to choose a starting dialogue. This also allows for some better organization when you are creating some neat dialogues. I do have a video on the features of this dialogue system if you want to watch it. But I'll leave the feature written on the screen right now if you don't open up the other video. For what we cannot do with this system, well, basically anything that's not showing in the screen. You will of course be able to update it to fit your needs if you want to. When making this system, I've watched a few tutorials but mainly watched this guy named Mert Kirim Gary. I'm sorry if I pronounced that wrong. He doesn't have everything I have, but also has some stuff that I don't have. Feel free to watch his videos if you prefer, or if you prefer mine, that's fine, whichever makes you understand things better. For this system, we are going to use the Unity Experimental GraphView API. The documentation isn't the best, but somewhat enough. Most likely because it is experimental, so anything can change and they don't want to add examples. This tutorial will use UI elements, but I won't be using any UXML on it, and everything is going to be through normal scripting. By the time I made this video, I haven't really finished the series, so if you are watching this when it came out, you can click on that bell notification button. I think it sends you a notification saying, hey, this guy posted a new video, so you will know when I post a new video of this tutorial. And then, when you are done, you can simply unclick it again and no more notifications should show up. If you are watching by the time I finish the series, a GitHub link for the final code should be in the description, in case you prefer that. It will be a bit of a long tutorial, but it should help you out understanding how to use the GraphView API. I'll be separating the videos as maximum as possible, so that you don't get saturated with really long videos, but some might still be long. Any feedback you have in any video, feel free to leave them in the comments of that specific video. Or if it's an overall feedback on the series, feel free to leave it in the comments of this video. And yeah, if you enjoy, feel free to subscribe as that helps out a lot. Regardless, I hope you enjoy this tutorial series.